Hello world, welcome to my channel. I am Sahil and today I am going to show you how to create an autocomplete search box using Bootstrap 4, PHP, MySQLi and Ajax. So before going to code, let's see how it works. This is the final output of our autocomplete search box page. Now as I enter any character or text in this text box, then it find record from the database and show a list of matching record in a list format. If no match found, then we will show a message no record. So let's see how it works. So when I type anything in this search box field, then it will show a list of matching records from the database, and if we write some text that is not matched with the database, then it shows no record. And if we click on any record, then it sets on the text field, and then after clicking on search button, we can get some details of this country. Okay, so let's create this autocomplete search box using PHP, MySQLi and Ajax. So for this, I have already created a database and a table inside this database, and I have also inserted some records, that is the name of some countries with their country code and a city related to that particular country. Okay, so now let's go to create this autocomplete search box. So for this, let's go to your htdoc folder and create a new folder inside this. So here I will keep my folder name auto_com. Okay, auto_com, and let's open this in a text editor. So our first file is index.php, so let's create it. And I will use Bootstrap 4 for designing the form. So we have to use Bootstrap CDN links, and I will also use Ajax. So I have to also add the jQuery library. So let's write the title first, and then I will go to the w3schools.com autocomplete search box using PHP, MySQLi and Ajax. Okay, so for CDN links of Bootstrap 4 and jQuery library, go to the w3schools.com, and from here click on learn Bootstrap 4 and click on Bootstrap 4 get started, and go below. Here you can see the CDN links of Bootstrap 4 and the jQuery library also. So just copy the all CDN links from here and copy it and paste inside the head tag. Now I will choose HTML because I'm coding in HTML right now for designing the form. So now inside the body tag, I will create a container. So div container, and inside this container I will create a row, and inside this row I will create a column md 8, and for centering this column I will use offset md 2. Okay, and I will also use bg light for background color of this column, and some padding 4 and margin top 3. Okay, now here in the body tag I will use bg info for background color of the whole body. Now inside this column I will create our heading tag. So I will use here h4 and class text center, and here I will write the same thing that is I have written in title tag. So just copy the same thing and paste here. Now inside this we will create our form, inline form. So before going to create our form, let's save this first and try to check in the browser. So localhost auto underscore com. Okay, now this is our heading and it's look perfect. Now we can also give a rounded view of this column. So now inside this heading I will create our form. So write form tag, and in action I will write details.php. I will create it later, so leave it for now. And I will use method post, and I will also use some class form inline, form inline and padding 3, form inline and padding 3. Now our first input field is for the input search box. So here write input type text name search id search and class form control and I will also use form control lg for some large view of this input field, and I will use rounded 0 for no round shape input field, and I will also use placeholder search. And one more thing, I will use some CSS style with equal 80%. Okay, now save this and let's check in the browser. So it's looking fine. Let's give some border color. So border info. Okay, now try to refresh. So this looks better. Now let's create the search button. So for button I will use input tag again, but now but in the type I will keep submit value search class button info button sorry info and button lg rounded 0, and here I will also use style, and here I will use width 20%. Okay, now let's save this, and now you can see this is looking perfect. Now below this form we will create another div for showing the list of fetched data from the database. So here I will write div call md5. Okay, call md5 and inside this div I will create another div class, div class list group, and here I will give ID. So later we will use this ID in Ajax. So here you have to write it. Now we will show the list dynamically from the database that we will find from the search, this search input field. Okay, so you can just create a static one to show how it looks. So for this I will write anchor tag, and inside this I will use some bootstrap classes, list group item, list group item, and list group, list group item, item action. Okay, and now here you can show the list, but I will here only show a static list to look how it, to show how it looks in the page. So here we can write some random data, list one, and we can keep some class border one for border. Okay, now save this and let's go to the page and refresh. So this list is showing here, so this is not looking good, so we have to set it here. So for this let's create one more three list. Now you can see, so we have to align with this search box. So for this go to this column, and here we have to write style, and here I will use position relative, and now margin top minus 38 pixel, and one more margin left, that should be 215 pixel. Okay, now let's check this. So now this is in the right place. Whenever we will write anything in this search box, then it will show dynamically the list from the database. Okay, so let's remove this, and we will use this anchor list group item in PHP code, so we will use it later, so keep it for now. And our design part is complete. Now let's go to code the Ajax. So for Ajax here we can write our Ajax code into this script tag. So let's quickly write the Ajax code, document.ready function, and now we will target our input field, that is this input. Okay, now using this ID search we will target this input text box, that is our search text box. So here we will write the ID search, and now I will use a jQuery function key up. Now this is an input event of key of keyboard. When we type any letter or any text from the keyboard, then it will fire this key up function. Okay, so just write function. Now inside this function, first we will create a variable where search text equal to, and here we will use this keyword and dot value. Now we will store the search text that is coming from this input field into this variable search text. Okay, now we will check using if condition. If search text not equal to empty, then we will write our AJAX code. So here we have to write and send a request to the server using this AJAX code. So here I will use URL action.php, sorry php, and method post and data. So what data we are sending to the server? So we are sending query, and what query? This search text. Okay, so we have to write search text here, and what will happen after successful? So here we have to write success function response, and here we have to target this ID, so list. Now whatever the response coming back from the server, we will show in this list group, so list, by using this ID. Okay, so just copy this so list, and here just write, and we will use HTML function here and just pass the response. Okay, now if the search text field is not empty, then it will execute this part, and if search field is empty, then we will use else, and here we can just write so list and HTML and make this empty. If no text is written in the text field, then we will show nothing in the main page. Okay, and one more thing we have to do is, so here write document dot on. Now click anchor tag. So we are selecting the anchor tag that is the list item. So we are selecting this anchor tag, and we are calling a function. Now what we'll do when we click on any list item, so we will do search. Now we are again targeting the search field, and here we will use bell, and we will set the list value into the text field. Okay, so here we will use this keyword, and here we will write text method. Okay, now it will set the list item text into the search box. Okay, and what to do next? Now here we will again when we click on the any search list list item, then it will set the text into the search box. Then we have to remove the all the list that is showing. So we have to again write HTML and make the this show list empty. Okay, so our Ajax part is also complete. Now we have to create this action.php. So let's copy this and we click create action.php, and here we will write our PHP code. So for this, first we will create the connection to the database. So for this we will write create a variable con, and here we will use new MySQLi, and here we have to write the server name localhost and username root, password is nothing, so leave this blank. And here we have to write the database name. So what is the database name? So you can see our database name is php_auto. So here php_auto. Okay, now we have to check using if statement connection connect error. If connection gets some error, then we will simply show a message die fail to connect. Okay, now here we will show the error message. So again connect error. Okay, so this is okay. Now inside this we will check using if it's set, and here we will use super global variable post, and in here we will use query because we are sending this query using jQuery method, Ajax method. So you can see we are sending this query, and this query contains the search text. And what is our search text? Thus our search text is the text that is written in this text field. Okay, so let's go to the action.php, and here we have to create one more variable input text. Okay, and we have to store the text that is coming using Ajax. So here we have to write query. Okay, now we have to run a query. So we have just created a variable query, and here we have to write select country from, country is the column name of our table, so from auto comp. Now auto comp is the table name where country, where country like. Now we will use like a clause here. So for this we have to just use this percentage sign, and then we have to pass the input text. Okay, now again we will use this percentage sign. Now our query is completed. Now we will create a variable result, and here we will use this con variable, and we will use this query. Sorry, now using this query method we will just pass the variable query. Okay, now again we will check a condition if result num rows. Now we are checking the number of rows coming from this coming from the database. Then if the number of rows is greater than 0, then we will execute this query. So here we have to write num underscore rows greater than 0, and here we are going to run a while loop, and inside this while loop we will create a variable row and equal to result, and we will use this fetch soc method. Okay, sorry, here spelling mistake. Fetch soc. Now inside this while loop we will use echo. Now in this echo we will simply show our list item. So just go to the index.php and cut this list item from here and let's paste it. Okay, now we have to change to the single quote here also, sorry, here and here, to write single quote. And now in here we have to use this, and inside this we have to select all the rows country. Okay, save this and just save this also. Now here we will show the list item dynamically. Okay, because we are showing using this success function. Okay, now if the number of rows is greater than 0, then this statement will execute, and if no record will match and fetched from the database, then we will execute this else echo. Now here we have to show the no record, so we will use p tag here, and here we will use some bootstrap class list group item and border one, and here we have to write no record. Let's close the paragraph tag. So this is ready. Now let's save and try to refresh this page. So now when I enter any text, then it's not showing and it's showing some error. So where is the error? So it's showing on line number 2. So what we have done mistake in line number 2. Oh, so we have an spelling mistake here. Host. Okay, now again refresh this. Now try to search. So it's working. So it's working fine now. Now whatever I am writing here, then it is going to the database and searching a pattern and fetch the matched record, and so in a list format here. Okay, you can see here, and when we click on any list item, then it will set the list item text into this text field, and whenever we click on this search box, then it is going to this details.php. but for now we did not created this details.php, so let's quickly create this details.php also to show the details related to this country. Okay, so come back to the our project, and here let's create details.php. okay, now here let's quickly write this, and we have to establish the connection to the database. So just copy the same thing from the action.php and paste here. Now again we will use if statement and it's set. Now this time we will use submit. We will check the submit button is clicked or not. You can see in the index.php we have an input type submit with name submit. So we are checking that if the button is clicked, then this will happen. Okay. So now I am going to create a variable data, and here I will keep the search text, whatever the text that is written in the text field, then we will store in this data variable. Okay. Now using this we will execute a query, select asterisk from auto comp is our table name, where country equal to this data. Okay. And again we have to create one more variable result, and using this con variable we will run our query, and here we have to pass this SQL. Okay. Now again create a variable row, and here using result we will fetch the details of that particular country by fetch assoc method. And now you can do anything, you can design anything as you want, but here I am only showing simple data, that is the ID, and here row ID is the column name, and here we can also br tag for line break, and just copy the same thing, and here we will use country and just write country name, just duplicate one more time country code, and here just write the column name country code, and just duplicate this, and here city. So here we have to write city. Okay. Now save this and let's try to. So this is our search box. Now whenever I enter any text, then the list is showing here. So when I click the text, then it will set to this text field, and when I click on this search button, then you can see here the details of the country is showing here. Okay, you can see here. Okay, so this is working fine guys. So if you like this video, then hit on like button and please subscribe to my channel.